would give you things to do behind the scene that don't nobody know. They don't know you. You can get away with that. You got away with it last time. The whispers of the enemy whisper in all our ears. Just do it in the dark.
They can't see you.
Hello, somebody. Sin feels good, but it's destruction thereof.
Oh, it feels good. Sneaking in the dark. You know when you was a little girl, a little boy, or a teenager, or even now.
When you're doing something, it feels good. Don't nobody know. But it's deteriorating. It's like cancer. Because of insecurity. Because of feeling, not feeling to handle failure. Failure is a good tool. You know that? Failure and haters are the best two you can have in your life. Because when you fail, that means you got to try harder. That means you haven't got there yet. That means there's still some places to go. That means you got to learn some more. Hello, somebody. And when people are talking about you, it keeps you on your knees.
Yes, yes,
it will. It keeps you going. It keeps you knowing. This must be something about, I told you, it's free advertisement. It must be something about me. Hallelujah, Jesus. It must be something about me that they are looking for. Past, trying to live in your past, to find your future in the past because of hurts of rejection and hurts of failure. Not telling the truth. Just say sometime you need help. I had to tell them, I need to call somebody. Because I got weak. I might be bold. I might not be insecure. But I'm a human being. And by me feeling weak, I could have faked the phone. Yeah. I could have acted like that thing got in my spirit. I could have acted like I was still walking on the water. I could have acted like, hello, somebody. But I know some praying people. I know some people that know God, so I have to call on help when I need help. That's why we know, that's why God said we're a family. He said encourage one another, lift one another up, bear one another's burdens. Amen?
Amen.
Proverbs 3:5 is the main verse I want to talk about because we got to talk about this trust thing. Why you don't trust people? Why are you scared to trust? Why are you insecure about people? God sees everything. He sees the thing that you don't see. He knows the hidden genders that the people, that if they got a hidden gender, if they using you, they only messing up. You need to be praying for them. Because God said, vengeance is mine. Touch not my anointed. Do my prophet no harm. His people, this is not his preachers and prophets. Do my people no harm. Hello, somebody.
Amen.
So that's why he told you this. Before we get to 3 and 5, let's just look at the guidance of the young. If you want to stay young, if you want to stay youth, if you want to stay in God, if you want to stay what God is doing, you have to be obedient. It says, my son, do not forget my law, but let your heart keep my commandments for length of days and long life. See, I want to be around him a while. My mama's 73, all my hair still ain't gray. Woo! I'm happy to look. I'm like, woo, mama! I'm looking forward to where I can look like this!
Amen.
Hello, somebody! Good stuff. You better look at your stuff where you come from. Look, you talk about getting married and so about to let's go visit your parents. Let's go visit your folks. Let's see what, you know, let's see on the ball, on the board. Let us see somebody. Amen? Hello, somebody.
Amen.
Let me see that gender. That's some stuff that's in you that come from somewhere. Let's see what it looks like.
Yeah.
Hello, somebody. Hallelujah, Jesus.
Hallelujah.
Lengthen your days. If you're obedient, your days will be long.
Amen.
If you keep having sin will deteriorate you, and peace they will add to you. Listen at this. Let not mercy and truth forsake you. Don't let the truth forsake you. You keep this truth, keep coming up, and you keep. If I had left that this time without saying it, see, this is a season of more than enough. Now God set that thing up where the man called. You know what I'm saying? I could have been.
I can't do it, girl.
No, I said it out in front of my congregation. Said, help me. See, when you keep stuff, the enemy said, don't nobody know, Steve. But I spoke it out. Hello, somebody. And I was able to get it out. Thank God. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Then it said, bind them around your neck. Write them on the tablet of your heart. And so find favor and high esteem in the sight of God and man. Saints of God, your youth will not come from makeup. We was talking about that yesterday. Your youth will not come from a new outfit. Your youth will not come for the money you can put in your pocket. Your youth will not come by how much you exercise in the gym. Your youth will not come about what somebody said. Your youth will only come by being obedient to the Lord. He said he will restore your youth unto you by telling the truth. And the truth hurts, but it won't harm you. The truth hurt. Everybody can't. You can't handle the truth. I was hurt for the people more than that. She said, God told you to do it. Don't you try to fix it. Oh, Jesus. Thank you, Lord. That was my release. Hello, somebody. Hello, somebody. Then it said, this is what I want us to get to right now. Trust in the Lord with all your heart and lean not unto your own understanding. Amen. Your understanding is, he's a thief. Why should I trust him? Your understanding is, I heard about what they did to so-and-so. Your understanding is, I don't even know them. Your understanding is, I can't trust everybody. Jesus. That's the ways of the world. Amen. Trust in the Lord with all thine heart. Lean not unto your own understanding. And all, not some, and all your ways, acknowledge him, and he will direct your path. I don't know about you, but GPS can't take me where God will take me. Help somebody.
Yes, God. Yes,
we was on the GPS looking at people's houses in the States. We couldn't see the ones in Sri Lanka like we wanted to do. Amen? So GPS can go, but God sees everything. Y'all better hear me because there's some good stuff here. I'm getting free of myself listening to it. Trust in the Lord with all thine heart. We say this all the time, but we ain't trusting in the Lord. We still hiding. We still got insecurity in our way. We still talking about, but you don't know what they did. But you don't know who they is. But God knew. God knows them more than they know them. And he said, trust in the Lord with all thine heart. Lean not unto your own understanding. Not your understanding of success. Not your understanding of knowledge. Not your understanding of education. Not your understanding of what you read. Tell me what I read in the book. I've been laughing at these today's parents all over the world. I learned how to just keep my mouth shut sometimes. I'm listening to my daughter-in-law talking about the little girl just 2 years old, doing all this, doing that, and said, Aubrey, you can't do it. I said, she need a butt booger. But they got this new, it's a new thing now. It's a new way now. It's the children way now. The Bible said, train them in the way that they should grow. When they go old, they will not depart.
Amen.
They're going to mess up in between.
Yes.
But because you planted that word in them, they'll come back every time. It ain't about your way.
Yes, amen.
It's only one way.
Yeah, yeah.
Lean not unto your own understanding.
Amen.
Things don't change because you jump on the scene. When you was born, the Bible was here. When you leave here, the Bible gonna be here. Before you got here, the Bible was here.
Amen.
The one who created us. The one who knows our wickedness. The one who knows who we are. He said, amen? Now don't get me wrong. When I said spank the butt, you don't necessarily have to whoop every child with a rod. You need to find out what makes that child remorse. One child I had to talk to, and I talked to him, he just, ugh. The other child just spanked his butt. One child I spanked, but he looked at me like, you ain't finished yet? I said, what kind of strong spirit is this? 4 years old before you give me a tip? That was a stubborn spirit. 4 years old, I was spanking that boy since he was old enough to say no, no, no. But he didn't give me a tip, not cry. He couldn't hold the tip. So he had one tip dropped out of his eye. One tip! That's stubborn. That's stubborn. But see, while we allow, what happened is, I didn't know that what he needed to make him remorse. I was spanking his butt, so I wasn't knowing, but I kept watching him. I kept watching him. And after that one tear, I realized this is a stubborn spirit. And it's growing in this little boy. When he was 5, he told Michael he did something and didn't tell Michael. He couldn't tell Michael, he got Michael under control. He let Michael go down for something he did. And then after looking, telling that boy, he was saying, I'm sorry, thank you, I'm sorry, thank you. But this particular thing he did at 5, I said, look at your brother eye and tell him you're sorry. Do you know that boy cried like somebody beat him to death? I said, what's wrong with you? He said, it hurt me to say I'm sorry. A 5-year-old boy? That's a stubborn spirit. Watch the gods that's growing in your children. Watch the gods that you're feeding in your spirit of your children. Because you are responsible for them. They already got to fight some battles when they get out there. They already got to go through something when they get out there. You are to help them get to that place that you know, so they won't have to face all that stuff. Amen. So I had to work on that spirit. Oh, I had to work on that boy. I had to work on that boy. And now he got his children, he got face.
And what do you think they got it wrong?
Amen. Then it says, in all thy ways acknowledge him to direct your path, if you acknowledge him. And he shall direct your path. Do not be wise. Some of y'all need to really listen to this one. Do not be wise in your own eyes. See, while you fearing the people you talking about you don't trust, while you fearing the situation that you don't trust, it says, fear the Lord and depart from evil. Because if you are insecure and looking at somebody from their past or something they do, that's wicked. Now you're doing tit for tat because you heard about them as a thief. Now you ain't even trust them. And you go at them, you look, they in your house and you look, see what room they went in. You got your purse, you double locking it.
Jesus.
Because you heard. He said, lean not into your understand. You might be the one to help them be free. By letting them know that you're not looking behind them. You're not watching over their back. You're not doing that. Amen? Hallelujah, Jesus. Then it says, I want to say this again though, be not wise with all your education, with all your experience, with all your knowing. Fear the Lord and depart from evil. It will be health to your flesh and strength to your bones. Thank you, Jesus, for taking care of these bones. Hallelujah. Mm-hmm. Honor the Lord with your possession. And with the first fruit of your increase. We're going to get on that this year. First fruit. So your barns will be filled with plenty, and your vats will overflow with new wine. My son, do not despise the chastening of the Lord, nor detest his correction. God chastens those we love. If sometimes I say something, or somebody says I do something that hurts your feelings, thank God. Because God loves you so much, he wants you to get it right.
Yeah.
Thank God you got somebody not scared to tell you the truth.
Amen.
Thank God you got somebody that ain't paying Are you all right? No, baby! You need to deal with that! Now, I had people to walk out of my life.
But I had something to come back to. I appreciate that. I thank you. You messed me up. You did this. But some of my life. But I ain't gonna stop telling no lie. I ain't gonna start telling no lie to make you feel good, because I fear the Lord. For whom the Lord loves, he correct. Thank you, Jesus, for correcting me. Thank you, Jesus. Say, thank you, Jesus, for correcting me.
Thank you, Jesus, for correcting me.
Thank you for loving me.
Thank you for loving me.
Thank you for chasing in me.
Thank you for chasing me.
Just as a father, see, that's where your parents listen. Just as a father, the son in whom he delight. Happy is the man who find wisdom and the man who gain understanding. You can read on to that. Stay in Proverbs, because you need to know that. The God of insecurity. The God of not trusting. Hallelujah, Jesus. Not trusting what someone say, always hiding who you are, attacking to protect. Those kind of people start talking to you first about all they know. Because they don't want you to know what they don't know. They start talking to you, they're talking about this, this, and that, because they don't want you to know that spot inside of them that's hurting, that they need to deal with. Because they don't want to deal with it. They put the God up, I got experience. So I don't have to deal with that. See, God want to clean us up, saints, so we can go to the next level. Are you ready to go to the next level? It's something in you that needs to get out the way. And I'm going to close right now. I want you to remember, keep this paper, please. Keep your paper so we'll keep making papers, because we're going to be talking about this God. And I want you to go to this verse. This one's going to be on top of this. The God on top of this is, turn to Proverbs 14 and 12. Eric, turn to 16 and 25. And somebody do 21 and 2. These ones we're going to come back talking about, your protection of the God of insecurity. 14 and 12, 16 and 25, 21 and 2. Everybody turn it, I want them to read that. 14 and 12, Proverbs 14 and 12. What does it say? Remember this now. 14, every generation, Jesus came down 14 generations, and 12 is the number of government. But you got to do this right here. You got to understand this right here. Read.
But the Lord reads, there is a way which seemeth right unto a man, but the end thereof are the ways of death.
I want you to read that again. Let her get there. Get there. Let her get there. Because you need to write this down in your pamphlet. You need to understand the God of insecurity, the G-O-D God, small, that we put on top. You need to understand that. You need to understand the little God that we... The God of insecurity is the G-U-A-R-D God. That's insecurity. But what we put on top of that is our way. Our way. I'm hiding this insecurity, God, because I'm going to do it my way. This is what works for me. This is the way I've been doing all my life. This who I am. Hello, somebody. Come on. Are you there? Okay, let's read again.
There is a way which seemeth right unto a man.
There is a way that seemeth right unto us.
But the end thereof are the ways of death.
But the end of it, you'll deteriorate. It's the ways of death. You are deteriorating because it's not your way. It's only one way. It's the way, the truth, and the life. No man can come to him but through Jesus. And Jesus is the truth. Hello, somebody. No way. Not your way. Not your mama way. Not your daddy way. Not your culture way. Not your religion way. Not your, oh no, it's not about you. It's about the way to get to where you got to go, and that's through the door. That's through the door. You see what I was talking about with the way and the door? Thank you for the lesson this morning. Come on. Next one, 21 and 2.
Proverbs 21 and 2.
Yes.
The king's heart is in the hand of the Lord.
Stand up, please.
The king's heart is in the hand of the Lord, like the rivers of water. He turns it to whatever he wishes. Every way of a man is right in his own eyes, but the Lord weighs the hearts. To do righteousness and justice is more acceptable to the Lord than sacrifice. A haughty look a proud heart and the plowing of the wicked are sin. The plans of the diligent lead surely the plenty, but those who everyone who is hasty surely true property.
Look at that. You on your way down and don't even know. She read more than that, but thank you for that. You on your way down more than you know. You proud. Look what I did. This is me. This is me. I can do this. You can't do it like me. Can't nobody do it like me. Da 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 da. By the song. Don't get it twisted. It's a song of freedom. It ain't a song of I'm so proud. I'm so this. He said, the king have rivers of water. If you stay with the king, you'll flow. The king of kings. But when you get to your way and what you know, and you think things are different because you learned something, or you can do something, or you can't nobody do it, baby, we are one body. That's why I want your gifts to operate. I don't want us to be, listen, it's time for the gifts of the people in the house. If you're a worshiper, worship. If you're a praiser, praise. If you're a teach, teach. If you're an intercessor, intercede. Whatever your gift is, this is your season, baby. Don't get twisted out of position. Position. Purpose is not pretty. That's the next season coming up. Remember that statement. Purpose is not pretty. But when you're in a position, the promise comes. The purpose of going through labor for 9 months, baby, your body get all out of shape, you get all wobbly wobbly, everything go out of your purpose, it ain't pretty. It ain't pretty. And then you have to get in position, legs all up in the air, people looking all up, up. But when the promise, hey! But when the promise come out, you like all that out wobble wobble, it looks good. The purpose of Jesus on the cross, it didn't look pretty. But the promise, I'm preaching my message out, that's next, let me get out of that. Purpose is not pretty. Hello, somebody. Come on. 1625. Y'all at there? 1625. Come on here.
There is a way which seemeth right unto a man, but the end thereof are the ways of death. The appetite of the laboring man laboreth for him, for his mouth urgeth him thereto. A worthless man deviseth in mischief, and in his lips there is a scorching fire. A perverse man scattereth abroad strife, and a whisperer separateth chief friends. A man of violence and teaseth his neighbor, and leadeth him in a way that is not good. He that shutteth his eyes, it is to devise perverse things. He that compresseth his lips, bringeth evil to pass. Mm. Continue.
You good right there? Say that last one again. It went further than I want, but I thank God they did. Come
he
on.
He that compresseth his lips, bringeth evil to pass.
Mm. Somebody get that another verse. What did they say in your verse?
Which
that
one?
Last one.
Which verse?
27.
Verse 3 or verse 4?
This is verse 30.
Verse 30? Second.
Verse 30.
A worthless man devises and digs up mischief, and in his lips there is as a scorching fire.
Mischievous.
He shutteth his eyes to devise all things, making his lips he bringeth evil to pass.
You think he's doing or she's doing the right thing, but they got hidden agendas. Mischievous. The deceiver deceives. The deceiver deceives. Mischievous. Proud. You looking on the outside, but there's something on the inside. Hello, somebody. Be careful of these gods. You could be entertaining them, or you could become with your own. Then we have to stay free. That's why I'm staying with these gods. Because there's some stuff in us that we need to get out. Mm-hmm. We don't even realize all the stuff that's in us. We try to go somewhere and do one thing and don't understand why we're not getting there. We get caught up in the wrong God. We get caught up in the wrong God. Remember about the dog that carried wrong? You might not have that God. But because you listen to that dog, good. Ain't nobody here? Where everybody at? Must be something wrong. Listen to the wrong God. Listen to the God what the devil wants you to hear.
Amen.
You didn't come here for nobody but yourself,
Amen.
I hope.
Amen.
You might have came here looking for somebody, but when you got here, you heard something.
Hallelujah.
You heard something.
Hallelujah.
And that's what you buddy. Stick to. He that hears what the Lord is saying. The Lord said, he that hears what the Lord is saying. Hear what the Lord is saying to you people today. God love you so much.
Amen.
Take down your gods. Get ready. Get excited to get yours. We're standing. Hallelujah.